The film screen was where he was, and there it was, Wallace and Cromwell.
I think you'll find this present a valuable addition to our modern lifestyle. They're techno trousers, ex-NASA, fantastic for walkies. All you do is attach the lead on her. Then program H. Reduce 10 minutes, 20 minutes up.
The voice of Peter Salas, who died at the age of 96.
Police headlines, Alex Jones. Police investigating Saturday's terror attack in central London are preparing to release the identities of the three knife men. One was of Moroccan origin and another was a 27-year-old Pakistani man. Labour has attacked Theresa May for cutting thousands of officers during her time in the Home Office. She has dismissed the criticism, insisting she increased counter-terrorism resources. And Peter Salas, the actor best known for his role in Clegg in the TV series Last of the Summer Wine, who was also famous as the voice of Wallace in the Wallace and Gromit films, has died aged 96. Nick Park, who created Wallace and Gromit, said he encapsulated the very British art of the droll and understated.
Well, as you heard, police numbers have been a big talking point today in the wake of the attack at London Bridge on Saturday. Our Home Affairs correspondent, Tommy Cashihan, has been beginning of the argument. Let's start with the numbers with the current state of police.
So, Eddie, it's beyond doubt that the total number of police officers fell about 19,000 down in 2010. But when it comes to the counter-terrorism side, the non-police is looking at the numbers. Last year, non-police employed its lowest level in recent years, just over 5,500, down to 7,000 in 2010. Since then, the numbers of Paris attacks, there's a basic change decision. Nobody was told about police and those numbers are creeping back up, and by this time next year, we'll be effectively back where we started at the same levels. Now, within this, this is where it's complicated, because there was a critics say we purposely cut our police and just raised them. What realistically happened to us as senior officers took the opportunity to retire during the cuts because this was once again with an expensive number of officers, that's just an organisation's work. New officers coming in tend to train differently, they have new tactics. So the game is effectively changed for them. Now I'll give you a good example. One of the tactics which we saw on Saturday night with these specialist teams of officers rapidly rushing in to confront one of the building suicide bombers, that's something they may not have done in the past. But they're now trained to be highly mobile, move a lot faster, be much more close to effectively special forces on the streets of the UK. So there's been lots of changes there. But the numbers are coming back